12 months on from his extraordinary Melbourne Cup winning ride, Jye McNeill has been honoured by his hometown. Racing's COVID protocols meant the Twilight Payment jockey couldn't attend the Lexus Melbourne Cup Tour in person. Nevertheless, he was celebrated in style.
Kerrang has been champing at the bit to celebrate the feats of a favourite son.
So I sent him a photo of the cutout that they got of him here and, so just to keep him involved.
Jye McNeill stunned the racing world last year, winning our great race on Twilight Payment. It was his first Melbourne Cup ride.
Twilight Payment, what a ride, what a win in a cup we'll never forget.
COVID restrictions prevented the star jockey travelling to the region, but the Lexus Melbourne Cup Tour gave locals a chance to recognise his win, and they raced to get a glimpse of the $250,000 trophy.
I won't wash my hands for a while.
McNeill attended Kerrang Technical High School and rode his first winner at the local turf club.
Part of a country town is you belong to the whole town, and everyone got a huge thrill during COVID out of it, and people still come up to us in the street and ask how he's going.
The town has a strong racing tradition. Flemington winner Jittery Jack is based at the Turf Club, which hosts two race meets every year.
Thoroughbred racing is really ingrained in Kerrang, and with Jye's win last year on Twilight Payment, that cemented that.
McNeill isn't the only cup-winning jockey to hail from the region. In 1948, 15-year-old Ray Neville became the youngest rider to win the race.
It just shows that wherever you are and wherever you come from, you can aim for these things, you know, and sometimes you don't even expect them, and there they are.
Kerrang is also one of the towns taking part in this year's Lexus Melbourne Cup National Sweep. If the town's barrier produces the winning horse, $50,000 will go towards a community charity. Kerrang has nominated Northern District Community Health as its charity of choice.
And we would invest it in trying to support our community to recover from the pandemic and to live their best lives.
Restrictions mean large Cup Day gatherings will be limited, but the locals will still get behind their hometown hero. Natalie Yanides for 10 News First.